Hello, everyone. I'm Li Xinyuan, a lecturer at Huawei. In the last lesson, we discussed how devices under our WLAN connect, and then we talked about several different access security strategies and modes, including link access and user access. Now let's start with the content of Lesson 7. We will look at WLAN data security. Once we are connected to WLAN, we need to ensure that the data we transmit is not susceptible to eavesdropping, meaning our transmitted radio waves should be encrypted. Otherwise, it is very easy for anyone with a device to know what data others are transmitting over Wi-Fi, which is quite alarming. Now, we have two encryption methods, TKIP, which stands for Temporal Key Integrity Protocol, and CCMP, Counter-Mode Cipher Block Chaining Message Authentication Code Protocol. WPA uses the TKIP encryption algorithm, which is much stronger than WEP. WPA2 uses the CCMP encryption algorithm, which utilizes the AES, Advanced Encryption Standard. A very difficult encryption standard to break, even supercomputers might take a long time to crack it. Therefore, WPA2 is currently considered relatively secure. As the protocols evolve, both WPA and WPA2 can use either TKIP or AES encryption algorithms. So we can choose between using WPA or WPA2 based on our needs. This is about secure encryption, ensuring that the data we transmit is protected from eavesdropping. Now, having discussed so much, let's summarize that our devices can have different security strategies to protect the data being transmitted. Now let's wrap up. Our devices can have different security strategies: open, web shared key, and then WPA and WPA2's PSK, and also 802.1x. Under these security policies, we have link authentication, access authentication, and encryption algorithms. Open, which means fully open, in which case these authentications are not required, but this is the least secure. Rarely anyone uses this. Unless you can ensure that no one can receive your network signal nor intercept your radio waves, then surely no one can eavesdrop. The second type is DEEP Open, which also uses open system authentication on the link. But for access, we can pair it with portal or MAC authentication in terms of access. We can connect to the system, but we need to perform an action on a page, for instance, entering a verification code or having an administrator pre-approve our MAC address. Then we can use it. Let's look at its usage scenario. Are you familiar with it? Does everyone find it familiar? In airports and train stations, which we have all visited, right? In airports and train stations, there are Wi-Fi signals from the airport or high-speed rail station. And once you connect, after connecting, you still need to perform additional steps, such as entering your mobile number on a web page, and then entering a verification code, and submitting that code before you can access the internet. Only then can you browse online. This is a typical security strategy similar to WPA Open. The third type is WPA Shared Key. In this case, access authentication does not involve, but here we have an encryption algorithm called RC4. This situation is used in networks where security requirements are relatively low. These types of networks are rarely seen nowadays, so using these few, these two are somewhat more common. In our homes, our home routers use WPA/WPA2PSK. This is the most common. Current mainstream routers, generally we set them to this mode. In this mode, our link authentication is also open, but access authentication requires the use of a pre-configured key, along with encryption algorithms to protect our data transmission. Usually you see in home users or small businesses, this type of router will use this method. It is mainly because it offers relatively high security, and most importantly, it's very cost-effective. For some large enterprise networks like Huawei's network, we generally use 802.1x authentication. And for access authentication, we use 802.1x, with encryption algorithms like TKIP or AES. In this mode, we need to use a radius server, which is quite costly, but offers very high security. These are the common access security strategies we see. Open WPA/WPA2PSK, and finally 802.1x. These three are relatively more commonly used. We have compared different security strategies just now. That concludes the content for Lesson 7.